One of the things we wanted to do in this one that we hadn't really had a chance to do in 5 was make sure that all of the kills play out in unexpected ways and in increasingly difficult situations.
It's cool because two of my guys, my two stunt performers, got cast as the bodega clerk. And then the first client in the line says, oh, there's a line here. And then he gets stabbed and all that. So these two guys are stunt performers. So no double, no, yeah. That makes my life so much easier.
We keep joking that this is a secret action movie.
Maybe not.
It's a secret
action movie.
It's not so secret action movie. You know, it's like, I mean, you know, the movies that we use as like touchstones for a lot of our stuff are like Terminator 2 and Aliens and these sequels that just flip the previous movie on its head. And so we were really conscious of that, Guy and Jamie were really conscious of that when they were writing it.
This version of Ghostface, to match kind of New York City, we wanted him to be really aggressive. We wanted him to be able to chase you into places you normally would think were safe, like a bodega.
You should feel safe in a large group of people. That's the rule of slashers, is if you make it to a large group of people, you know, you found safety and someone's gonna call the cavalry in and you'll be saved. And we thought, well, what if this guy, you know, this version of Ghostface, that doesn't stop him.
It doesn't help.
He's relentless, it doesn't matter, he doesn't follow the rules of slashers.
People might be taken aback by the gore. Scream has always been funny, and I love that aspect, and there's definitely some of that too, but I do think that with each film, Ghostface he's getting more intense.
We love floppy Ghostface from the early movies that gets knocked down easily and gets right back up. But in this one, it was a little more like, what if he was a little more relentless, a little more driven, and just doesn't give a shit about anybody? So if you get in his way, he's gonna stab you too.
Yeah. I mean, like, Ghostface in a bodega with a shotgun is just the most ridiculous, absurd thing. And I remember seeing it for the first time on the monitor and just being like, what are we doing? But then they're on board or they're not after the scene, right? We get them and they're on the ride or they're not. And we're thankful that it turned out as well as it did.
We had a lot of discussion about it. How many times he shoots the gun? How many people does he shoot? That sequence delivers for what it is, right? It is very specific in the bodega, how it plays out, and unbelievably scary when it's happening. And you buy that this Ghostface will do things that no other Ghostface has been willing to do.
It was always the assignment. How do we take that thing that feels or starts in a way that's familiar and then it just goes off the rails?
That's also the beauty of Scream, is that the whole point is heightening things to a level where you might think it's unbelievable, but because it's this world, it is believable. This specific Ghostface is the most ruthless and crazy and tough. And I mean, it's definitely, the writers took it to another level.
There's a relentlessness, there's a brazenness that is unique to this specific Ghostface. New York kind of set the table for us in a way. It had to be believable in a different way, right? We had to ground the action in a different way. And that feels violent and powerful in a way that maybe we haven't always seen from Ghostface.
Yeah, well, that was a part of the challenge, you know, like it's the sixth one, so you gotta stay true to what's been done before, you know. It's not like you all of a sudden the Ghostface is a ninja, and you know, like, so you gotta keep true to the style. So it's kind of keeping the action simple but making it cool at the same time. So it's that kind of you gotta find just the right amount, you know.
Speaking of collaboration, you're blocking it on the day, and Melissa had a great note. She was like, I would do something, my character would do something more here. The scene is missing, it's missing a moment. So we took a step back, and in a matter of a few minutes, designed that moment where they get behind the end cap of the aisle, and Sam grabs the beer can and throws it to misdirect Ghostface. That whole little moment, that little bit of do-si-do of cat and mouse, which really is where so much of the tension of that sequence lives. That came of the experience of trusting Melissa, and Melissa trusting us, and the sequence is so much better for that.